If you've been using the 3DEXPERIENCE platform to store your CAD data, you might have noticed that it behaves a little bit differently to the Windows file system you've probably been using until now. The platform is a database, so when trying to find your data, you need to apply different techniques rather than just endlessly browsing through a folder structure filled with folders and subfolders. This is where the concept of 6W tags comes in. 6W, which stands for what, who, when, where, why, and how, tags are essentially filters. Imagine you're shopping on Amazon or eBay. If you're like me, you probably enter some search term, and then you use filters to narrow down the hundreds or thousands of search results. 6W tags in the platform work the exact same way. Let's take a look at a couple of examples. I'll run a search for my content. This is every piece of content I've ever saved into the platform. You can see that returns over 1,000 results, way too many for me to make any use out of. So now this is where I can start using my tags, activated by the little luggage tag symbol to the right of the search bar at the top. And my tags are activated. There are default tags provided with the platform, so I might want to start filtering by type, so maybe I'm only looking for drawings or perhaps parts and assemblies. So we can see starting filtering down a set of results created by me, perhaps within a certain date range, and I might want perhaps a specific material, so we can have our information and metadata from SOLIDWORKS, our custom properties, as tags in the platform. So if I want to perhaps look for all files which have material of plain carbon steel, well, there we go. Very quickly, I've gone down from 1,000 results to something much more manageable, 17 results. And I can continue kind of stacking tags on top of one another, maybe only looking at the latest revision, part of a particular project, whatever I might need. Once I've got my results, I've got all of the information listed here, I can click on any result and get a handy preview, as well as look at all of the attributes here on the right hand side. And I can also take a look at where is this part being used, what assemblies, but also perhaps does it have any documentation attached to it as well. So all of that information is at my fingertips. Let's take a look at another example. So running that search again, and we can delete our tags at any point. So if we start from our broad search again, that my content, activate our tags, switch to our single product. Another example we might want to do is, well, what parts are released, what is in work, and we can access that with our maturity state. So I can see I've got many more parts that are still in work as opposed to released. So again, we can just simply go ahead and say in work, and it will filter down to all of those different results there. So I can see I've got some work to do in getting these parts up to scratch and then getting them released for manufacturing and production. As a bit of a bonus, you don't have to start a search to use 6W tags. You can filter and start using the tags on active content as well. Let's take a look at an example of that. I'm going to pull up this app here to look at a structure view. We'll take a look at this assembly. And what we'll see is that this assembly opens in both a tree view here on the left-hand side and a 3D view on the right-hand side. And the apps are in sync with cross-highlighting enabled between the two in both directions, as well as me perhaps taking a look at what, you know, level I might want to select something at, whether it's a sub-assembly or just the particular parts itself. Now, the real power of 6W tags can be used in 3D to visualize and get an insight into your designs on the content. So I can start using my material, I can start using my maturity state, but even more than that, I can colorize the data. So you can see it color codes the objects in my design based on the particular tag or attribute that I've chosen here. So material is the example that I've used. Again, an obvious one might be if you've got parts in work versus released, or it might be things like how many parts in this assembly are made versus by. So this all leads to a much deeper level of insight into your designs just using the attributes and information you've already put into your designs. So there you have it, a quick overview of using 6W tags in the platform. If you have any questions or want to get in touch with us about the 3DEXPERIENCE platform, please contact us. Thank you.